In June 2018, the president of Uganda officially opened the Entebe Express Highway for public use after 4 years of construction by the China Construction Communication Company. Since then to date, Ugandans have been using the highway without paying any fees, despite knowing that eventually a toll free will be levied. Today, it was announced by the Uganda National Roads Authority that road users will start paying toll fees to pay back the $470 million loan that was used by government in the construction of the road. According to the Minister of Works and Transport, General Katumba Wamala, the public will pay between 3,000 to 18,000 shillings, depending on the type of the vehicle.
UNRWA will ensure that no single coin is lost, and all funds which will be collected go towards the operations and maintenance of the road, as well as the repayment of the loan which we borrowed to do the road.
According to UNRWA, Class 1 vehicles such as motorcycles will pay 3,000 shillings at the toll. Class 2 vehicles, which are light vehicles with two axles, will pay 5,000 shillings. Class 3 vehicles that are light vehicles with three axles or more, and medium vehicles with two or three axles, will pay 10,000 shillings. Class 4 vehicles, which are large goods vehicles and buses with four or five axles, will pay 15,000 shillings, whereas large good vehicles with six or more axles will be required to pay 18,000 shillings. According to the Uganda National Roads Authority, the Kampala Entebbe Expressway is a four-lane highway comprising of two sections: the 37.23-kilometer section from Busega to Entebbe International Airport, of which 27 kilometers is limited access expressway, and the 14.13-kilometer section from Kajansi to Munyonyo through Weza, totaling to 51.36 kilometers. General Katumba Wamala hopes that after 20 years, Uganda will have finished to pay off the loan to Exim Bank of China. The road users have now been given a grace period of 2 months, November and December. Then effective January, the users will begin to pay the stipulated fees.
The 1st of December. If not, then stretching it further would be the 1st of January. But we'd love to see that work. If you can move faster, do all the education, check the system back and forth, we still have a window of 1-2 months for us to start enforcing.
Only few categories of vehicles have been exonerated from paying.
Emergency vehicles of the fire brigade and ambulances, and two, the presidential convoy.
According to the road designer from UNRWA, Engineer Patrick Muleme, border riders are not allowed on the highway.
And the reason is simple. A border will not be able to drive at the speed of the expressway, and for that reason they endanger other motorists.
Aegis Group, a French multinational company involved in the areas of infrastructure and transport systems, planning, water and environment, was contracted to handle operations and maintenance for a period of 5 years. Story by Chris Samakula for CTV PM Edition.